started thinking that I know the meaning of feeling like you're losing your game. I get it twisted, but I can't help believing that if things were right, I wouldn't come.
My name is Andrea Cortez, and I'm the founder of Tainted Ink. I have been blessed with the gift of vision, and we have an amazing team and a collective of artists that work all around me to support and make this what it is.
My name is Alyssa Haley, and I'm a co-founder here at Tainted Ink. My specialty is in hair care. I love all things that are funky and fun and bold, and to be able to incorporate them with a beautiful team and create beauty on so many different levels is my passion.
I am Zachary Kelly. I am a co-founder here, and my specialty is in skincare. I always say, what Andrea always says is really cool, that you're married to skincare, you have an affair with makeup, and I think that's really cool for me to be able to have skincare services here now.
We are Tainted Ink. We are Hartford's first official makeup studio. We do not sell products. We really focus on service and exceptional education for women. We work on empowering and really finding that inner working of a woman that makes her feel beautiful from the inside out. We've been in business for just under 3 years. We're in our second location. We do hair, skin, and makeup, and offer services in all three worlds. What we're known for best, we were featured in the Hartford Current for teaching women how to use what they already own. So women will bring their things to us, and we'll help them understand how to use the products that they already own and then give suggestions based on what they would benefit from.
Tainted really offers a different type of approach, where the cosmetic industry really has focused on insecurities of women and utilizing those insecurities to sell them products. What we do is on the complete opposite spectrum. Versus finding out what their concerns are, we find out their relationship with beauty and with makeup and really kind of hone in on what they are most confident about and elevate that and really develop their confidence through that, through who they are as a person, what makes them feel beautiful. And that's something that's really kind of shaking up the cosmetic industry.
I always find it very interesting when people ask us, you know, what is your business?
Yeah.
So we are artists and entrepreneurs, and that is who we are. We have found a way to express ourselves, truly express ourselves with our passion, and help other people, in particular women, find that same self-expression, and we found a way to make it sustainable for us. And that's really the best definition of who we are and what our business model is.
Take the leap of faith. Honestly,
good.
It's myself and Andrea have for 15 years climbed the corporate ladder, and we were very successful in what we did. And I have never been more personally, artistically, or emotionally fulfilled until I became an entrepreneur and really just stepped outside of what was comfortable and came into this, which is the biggest gift I have ever received. And I hope that anyone who wants to be an entrepreneur or business leader or whatever it may be, whatever your passion is, go for it.
My advice for entrepreneurs, I'm gonna basically crack the code for everybody that's like, should I do it, should I not do it? If you're an entrepreneur, you are born to do it.
Yeah.
You know that you are meant to do it. You will hear a voice inside of your head that's like, you can't work for other people, you probably talk a lot, you get in trouble a lot. There are characteristics of an entrepreneur. You're reckless in a sense, because that is a definition. You risk it all for the vision. And when you have it, you know it. And even there'll be signs. So it's exciting because these moments when somebody speaks to you, you know truth when you hear it. And you'll hear this little ping inside and like, that's it. And when you take the leap of faith and you believe it so strongly in your mind that you can taste it and feel it, and then you do the actions and take responsibility, the universe, God, whatever you want to call it, can't help but to conspire with you to take you where you ultimately are meant to go.
I was very wound up in a business desk job for many, many years. And I think just growing into myself and really figuring out who I am and really embodying being an artist and really creating and creating my life and creating exactly what I want my day-to-day to be has been the biggest gift and also the biggest shock of my life. But I know that I'm living with passion and with purpose and really fulfilling my day-to-day as I go because I'm creating the life that I want. And there's nothing better than that. We're all human and we make mistakes. I'm not perfect, I might need a second take, but please don't judge me. I am born and raised in Hartford.
Yeah.
My love for Hartford runs so deep. My mom is a first generation here. Like, this is my home. This is everything for me. So to find and meet like-minded people that share the same passion and share the same vision, and to really work closely with them and share our dreams and create something right here in my backyard is, it's invaluable because the change that we all want and we all need, everyone thinks you need to go somewhere else to find something beautiful when it's really right here in your backyard. So for me, there would be no other place but Hartford because this is where my heart lies. So I'm just very blessed to have found people that are here in our community and people that feel so strongly as I do.
I am so proud of this community because of all the amazing people who are here who want to make a difference. A lot of people say that Hartford is a dying city, and in actuality, it's not. It is thriving, but it takes people with vision, it takes people with passion and purpose to really elevate it to what it can and will be. And that makes me very proud. And I was born and raised in this area. And, you know, coming from just over the river in East Hartford, I used to think, ooh, Hartford, no way. Oh, it's scary, this and that. And to now be a business owner in Hartford, it is game changing. It is, every day is there something beautiful that I experience. And to get to know people in so many different businesses, or from business owners in the restaurant industry to artists, to people who are teaching, to people who are mentoring, to people, you know, beautiful drag queens who are trying to make a difference and just really making a change and trying to do better every single day. And that inspires me consistently.
I am not from Hartford. I am originally from Richmond, Virginia. I am a wanderer. I have a restless spirit. And I have to be very honest with you. There is a kind of magic that is moving through Hartford that if you don't know it, it's just not meant for you yet. But it is coming. Coming from an art community, the art world is ready to embrace the change. And where people that are conservative in tradition are unsettled with what's going to happen, let me be one of the people, your neighbor, that is telling you it's going to be okay, because I personally know hundreds of amazing people alone that live in the West End that are passionate, that are resilient, that really truly want to make a difference, really do. And it's because of the times that we're living in, everyone is being called to do more than they ever thought that they really needed to do. And illusions are being shattered, and we are in a beautiful place. Artists are connecting, small businesses are connecting, and it's changing. And so if you don't know how great Hartford is, please come to Tainted, spend one day with me, one day, morning to night, and you won't leave and go anywhere else. I'm not perfect, I might need a second take, but please don't judge me. And I won't judge you. You do what you will and I won't do what I won't. Like, and who doesn't, I think it's dope. No matter nationalities, everybody has qualities. Personally, I think my passion makes stop my personalities. Martin Luther King, he had a dream. That dream was for you, that dream was for me. Don't sit at my table for the content of my character. Please don't choose to let two shoes scare. Yeah, we all need love, we all need.
matter the what, we all need love. We all need love, no matter the why, no matter the what.
Why that sex, man.